But we also possess an inner hero. If stirred to action, that inner hero is capable of performing tremendous goodness for others. Another conclusion from my research is that few people do evil and fewer act heroically. Between these extremes and the bell curve of humanity are the masses, the general population, who do nothing, who I call the reluctant heroes, those who refuse the call to action and, by doing nothing, often implicitly support the perpetrators of evil. So on this bell curve of humanity, villains and heroes are the outliers. The reluctant heroes are the rest. What we need to discover is how to give a call to service to this general population. How do we make them aware of the evil that exists? How do we prevent them from getting seduced to the dark side? We don't yet have a recipe for creating heroes, but we have some clues, based on the stories of some inspiring heroes. I love the story of a wonderful 9-year-old Chinese boy, who I call a dutiful hero. In 2008, there was a massive earthquake in China's Sichuan province. The ceiling fell down on a school, killing almost all the kids in it. This kid escaped, and as he was running away, he noticed two other kids struggling to get out. He ran back and saved them. He was later asked, "Why did you do that?" He replied, "I was the hall monitor. It was my duty, it was my job to look after my classmates." This perfectly illustrates what I call the heroic imagination, a focus on one's duty to help and protect others. For him, it was cultivated by being assigned this role of hall monitor. Another story, Irena Sendler was a Polish hero, a Catholic woman who saved at least 2,500 Jewish kids who were holed up in the Warsaw ghetto that the Nazis had erected. She was able to convince the parents of these kids to allow her to smuggle them out of the ghetto to safety. To do this, she organized a network. That is a key principle of heroism. Heroes are most effective not alone but in a network. It's through forming a network that people have the resources to bring their heroic impulses to life. What these stories suggest is that every one of us can be a hero. Through my work on heroism, I have become even more convinced that acts of heroism don't just arrive from truly exceptional people, but from people placed in the right circumstance, given the necessary tools to transform compassion into heroic action. Building on these insights, I have helped to start a program designed to learn more of heroism and to create the heroes of tomorrow. Each of these statements is valid after controlling for all demographic variables, such as education and socioeconomic status. Heroes surround us. 1 in 5, 20%, qualify as heroes, based on the definition of heroism I provide above. 72% report helping another person in a dangerous emergency. 16% report whistleblowing on an injustice. 6% report sacrificing for a non-relative or stranger. 15% report defying an unjust authority. And not one of these people has been formally recognized as a hero. Opportunity matters. Most acts of heroism occur in urban areas, where there are more people and more people in need. You're not going to be a hero if you live in the suburbs. Not much happens in the suburbs. Education matters. The more educated you are, the more likely you are to be a hero, I think because you are more aware of situations. Volunteering matters. 1/3 of all the sample who were heroes also had volunteered significantly, up to 59 hours a week. Gender matters. Males reported performing acts of heroism more than females. I think this is because women tend not to regard a lot of their heroic actions as heroic. It's just what they think they are supposed to do for their family or a friend. Race matters. Blacks were 8 times more likely than whites to qualify as heroes. We think that's in part due to the rate of opportunity. In our next survey, we're going to track responses by area code to see if in fact these heroes are coming from inner cities. Personal history matters. Having survived a disaster or personal trauma makes you 3 times more likely to be a hero and a volunteer. So every person is part of humanity. Each person's pulse is part of humanity's heartbeat. Heroes circulate the life force of goodness in our veins. And what the world needs now is more heroes, you. It's time to take action against evil.